Hi everyone, my name is Junyi Zhu. I'm currently a PhD student from MIT CSEL, HCIE group, working with Professor Stefanie Mueller. Today I'm presenting EIT-kit, an electrical impedance tomography toolkit for health and motion sensing. Electrical impedance tomography, or EIT, is a non-invasive imaging technique that measures conductivity, permittivity, and impedance of object. As you can see on the left, it works by attaching electrodes to the surface of the subject, in this case, my thumb. Then use the electrodes to either inject current or measure the resulting voltages. Based on the voltage measurement data, it can reconstruct an image of the subject's internal conductivity.
Traditionally, EIT sensing was mainly used for professional medical applications in hospitals for visualizing the inner structure of a part of the human body, such as lung function monitoring and tumor and cancer detection, due to its large, expensive hardware setups, as well as complicated image reconstruction algorithms.
With the development of low-cost electronics and the availability of open-source EIT image reconstruction libraries, HDI researchers start to use EIT sensing to build novel applications, such as tactile sensing, hand gesture recognition, and user identification detection. However, designing custom EIT devices is still hard. To start with, users need to design the form factor of the measuring device to ensure constant contact between the electrodes and the subject, which depending on the measurement location and electrode distributions. These things are different each time across different human subjects. Next, custom EIT sensing applications often need to design a custom sensing board from scratch, since commercial boards do not provide enough options to support different EIT configurations. To make things worse, some electrical signal parameters, such as injecting AC current amplitude, frequency, and voltage measurement gain, needs to be optimized and calibrated each time. As you can see on the left, with the identical signal applied to different body parts, even for the same human subject, can end up with very different results. Last but not the least, while the open source EIT image reconstruction libraries, such as errors, are very powerful, they only work for desktop applications, but not for mobile devices. If you're trying to build a more portable EIT devices for outdoor environment, you will need to write your own visualization library. In order to make EIT sensing more accessible and easier to use, we built EIT-kit. EIT-kit supports users across different stages of EIT device development. With EIT-kit, users without EIT sensing knowledge can design and fabricate novel applications with EIT sensing technology. EIT-kit contains four components: a 3D editor for personalizing the form factor of electrode arrays and the electrode distribution, a customized EIT sensing motherboard for performing electrical impedance measurements, a microcontroller library that automates signal calibration and facilitates data collection, and a mobile visualization API for interpolating, then visualizing the measured data on mobile devices. Let's look at the EIT-kit 3D editor first. EIT-kit's 3D editor is built as a plugin for Rhino Grasshopper. Users start by importing a 3D model of the subject to be measured, in this case, a 3D scanned format model. User then specify the sensing area by marking the corresponding faces. EIT-kit will automatically generate a form factor that fits tightly around. User next specify the sensing resolution by selecting electrode types and number of electrodes. Instead of just sensing evenly, user can also customize electrode distribution to create a higher sensing resolution in a specific area. Once satisfied with the design, users can export the design as a 3D printable file. The electrode spaces in the corresponding locations are saved with the model, as you can see in the video. We will then look at the EIT sensing motherboard. EIT sensing motherboard automates the EIT signal calibration and measurements for different electrode configurations. On the main board, it contains the current drive circuit, a voltage measurement circuit, and a control circuit. Both the differential current source and differential voltage measurement are modulated by digital rheostats, so that users have full control over the EIT sensing-related electrode signal parameters. The main board can be flexibly extended to a stack of modular MUX boards. Together, it supports up to 64 electrode and up to 4 electrode arrays simultaneously. Once I have all the hardware set up ready, let's move on to the microcontroller library. Users start by importing the EIT-kit Arduino library, then construct a library object with measurement configurations. In the case of the armband I just showed you, we have 16 electrodes, single electrode array measurement with 4 terminal configuration. After that, users can start the measurement by simply calling the take measurement function. As you can see on the serial monitor and oscilloscope at the bottom, the library auto-calibrate the injecting current and voltage measurement gain for the measuring object, then starts the EIT data measurements. Once users have the measured EIT data ready, they can move on to the mobile visualization API, which communicates to the EIT-kit microcontroller library via Bluetooth. The EIT-kit mobile visualization API is built on Xcode and can be used on iOS devices, such as iPhone and iPad. Similar to the microcontroller library, user will start by creating an empty object in Xcode IDE, importing EIT-kit image reconstruction API into the project. Then user will initialize the UI view controller template, as well as the Bluetooth. Here they will set up number of electrodes and measuring configurations as in 2 or 4 terminal measurements. Next, user will call the process string function, which solves the conductivity distribution. Then add mesh to view, which applies the solved result and map onto mesh faces. Finally, upload to the mobile device, and you can see the 2D visualization of the EIT data in real time. Apart from the 2D visualization, EIT-kit mobile visualization API also supports 3D view and AR view. For the 3D view, simply add the initialized 3D view inside of the view did load function. And then instead of add mesh to view, we do add 3D mesh to view to apply the solved conductivity onto a 3D mesh. Again, build an update to the mobile device and see the EIT data visualized in 3D. For EIT AR visualization, users will change the app scene view to the AR view. Rebuild the application, and you can see the EIT data visualized in AR environment. Now that I have shown you each component of the EIT kit, I'll briefly demonstrate its applicability with a range of EIT devices designed via EIT kit that supports different sensing applications. First is an AR muscle monitor for physical rehabilitation. This device can sense muscle strain and tension in the thigh to monitor muscle activities. In the app view, the red parts indicate the muscle tense, while blue parts shows the muscle stretch. As you can see in this video, the device uses 2 electrode arrays, 16 electrodes each, to create a 3D volumetric rather than 2D sectional image of the thigh, which provides more data on the muscle engagement and reduces the measurement error due to the EIT device shifting during the movement. The visualization is displayed in AR environment over the LAG's 3D model to further illustrate the muscle activity location in real time. We also built a variable hand gesture recognizer. This application demonstrated that EIT-kit can help users quickly prototype EIT devices for classic EIT applications, such as gesture recognition, which is one of the main benefits of a toolkit. Next is a non-intrusive distracted driving detection device. This EIT device can identify which hand of the user has on the steering wheel while driving. This sensor on the hand approaches can also be used to monitor driving habit and remind the user to switch hands to avoid pain on long drives if one hand is overused. Finally, to demonstrate that EIT-kit's capability of sensing biological tissues, we build a biological tissue visualizer, where a cross-cut piece of meat is used to closely emulate human tissues. Thank you so much for attending the session. I'm ready to answer any questions.